Love is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Come in, Xiaolong. Here we are. Do you like it?
Uncle Chao, so is this really your house?
What do you mean? Xiaolong, did you think I'd take it to someone else's house? Huh? Here in America, I'm just an average person. A common man. I bet you thought I was a big businessman, huh?
No, I didn't.
My wife has a lingering illness. So when I went back to Hong Kong, I made an effort to find two Chinese herbs that the American Chinese traders needed. In exchange for those herbs, I'll have enough money to cover my wife's hospital bills. But for now, she's in a place where she can rest before they start her treatment.
I see. How's Auntie? May I see her?
You don't have to see her right away. Don't worry. After her treatment, I'll let you visit her at the hospital. All right? Let's clean this house a bit, okay? Then you may rest afterwards. I'll go out and send a telegram to your father. I'll inform him that we got here safely.
I'll go with you.
No, stay here.
Uncle? Where do I sleep?
You're worried about that? Come here, I'll show you. Is that okay with you? It's not as big as your room in Hong Kong, but it's cozy. Not bad for us Chinese immigrants. I have to go now.
Wait, Uncle Chao, after cleaning and resting, what do I do next?
Xiaolong. Listen to me carefully. From this day on, you must learn to take care of yourself. I'll see you later. Bye. From this day on, you must learn to take care of yourself.
Thank you. This is his resume.
Thank you.
Please wait here.
What kind of job are you looking for?
Well, I can do anything. I'm strong.
We're hiring people who are willing to collect the trash. Are you up to it?
Really? You hire people to collect the trash?
Don't worry. It's not that difficult. You just have to put all the garbage in the trash bins.
Okay. What about the pay?
We pay weekly. Your salary will depend on how much work you can do.
I can do the work of two people.
All right, then. I'll put your name on our list. If you don't mind doing manual labor, you'll earn more money.
Really?
Of course.
All right. I'll take the job.
Okay, bye.
Hello.
Hi. Sign here, please. And here's your money. Thank you.
Thanks. Oh, hi, Uncle. When'd you come back?
Just this morning.
So, how was the trip? How's Auntie?
Still the same. You're right on time. Let's have dinner. Sit down. I prepared something special
for you. It's okay. I've had dinner.
You've had dinner?
Yes.
At a restaurant?
Uncle Chow, look at this. See? This is the first money I've made here in America. Huh? $100.
How did you get that much money?
I'll tell you later. Here, for this month's rent.
What?
Take it, Uncle, please.
But, Xiaolong.
No buts, Uncle. The rest of it you may spend on Auntie's medicine.
Okay? No, Xiaolong, this is your money. I can't accept it.
I'll be fine, Uncle. Please, take it. Sit down. I'll get you something to eat. Let's fill your bowl, okay?
What?
Ma'am, let me help you with those vegetables.
Hey, I need those cocoa chicken right now for a stew order, for sweet and sour pork.
Oh, Becky, wait.
What is it?
Let's watch a movie after work.
What? Mind the chicken, Chef Wong. I'll be back for those dishes, okay? Now look here, I need you to focus on your work, Chef. Stop harassing the waitresses. I don't want our customers to complain.
Excuse me.
Do your job well.
Ma'am, you have a visitor.
All right, hurry up. You too, okay?
Yes, madam.
James,
hi.
It's you. How
yes,
are
it's me.
You? I thought you were still in Hong Kong.
Well...
When did you arrive?
Just a few days ago.
What can I do for you?
I hope you don't mind. It's just a small favor. I came here to ask for your assistance.
What kind of assistance?
I can't say it's a good thing. It might even be troublesome for you.
Tell me.
I have a young friend. I was wondering if you could hire him
to work at your restaurant.
Oh, James. I'm so sorry. I can't hire your friend. My staff's complete.
I know that. But he's really a good young man. I worry about him. I don't think living alone in San Francisco would do him any good. It would be best for him to settle here in Seattle. That way he'll be able to continue his studies. At least finish high school.
So your young friend is Li Xiaolong, knows how to dance the cha-cha, and does martial arts.
Right.
He's also a boxing champion. But I don't understand. Why would a young man, obviously talented and smart, want to work at a restaurant?
Well, the truth is, it's a long story. I'll explain it to you some other time, okay? In the meantime, I really need your help. You wouldn't turn your back on a fellow Chinese, right? And besides, you're the only person I know in Seattle who has good connections.
Oh?
If that's not too much, you can also recommend a good school for Xiaolong.
On that matter, I can be of help.
Thank you. I do hope he can work here. If not, maybe you can help him find another job while he's attending school, huh? With him under your care, I can reassure his parents that their son is safe and doing well here in America.
Well, James, I did not expect this. All right. I'll try to help your young friend. But take it back, please.
You don't understand. This money isn't for you. Ruby, I want you to use this for Xiaolong's salary. Practicing Kung Fu.
Uncle Chow.
Huh?
I haven't seen you for several days. Where have you been?
I went to Seattle.
Seattle?
Yeah.
Why'd you go to Seattle?
I went there to conduct some business and to find a good school for you.
Uncle Chow, I just want to work. I don't want to go to school anymore.
Bruce, you're now in America. You need to study if you want your future to look bright. Otherwise, you'll end up just like me.
I don't need to study. I can be a boxing champ here.
There are many boxing champs in America. They don't need another one. Reach for another goal. Something more practical. Bruce, pack your things. You're going to Seattle.
What? To Seattle?
Yes, when you get there, call that number. Begin a new life in Seattle.
So you want me to go to Seattle right now?
That's right.
You just want to get rid of me.
That's not true. I want you to live a better life. So use this bus ticket I bought for you. Forget this.
too, sir.
Find the cheap place where I can stay for the night.
Okay. Japanese?
Do I look like one of you?
So how do you say hello in Japan, huh?
How should I know? I'm not Japanese, I'm Chinese.
Huh? How come your hair is not long and braided? Oh, I'm sorry. But you can't blame me, I see it in the movies all the time. Chinese men always have long braided hair, just like women. I didn't think you were Chinese because, you're too good looking.
Just shut up and drive, okay?
Okay. Oh, good, you're awake. We're in the suburbs west of Seattle.
Wait, why are we in the suburbs? Why'd you bring me here, huh?
Huh? You told me to find you a cheap motel.
Yes, but I didn't tell you to come all the way here.
There are lots of cheap motels here.
Stop the car. $75?
Of course, you slept for 3 hours.
Why didn't you wake me then?
What? Are you out of your mind? I can't wake my passengers without their permission. That'll be rude.
I only have $70.
Well, if that's the case, then I'm afraid I have to drop you off here.
You can't do that. You took me here, so you'd better take me back.
It's not a problem. I can take you back. But you don't have enough money.
There, you can have it all.
You still owe me $5.
Take me back to the city.
What? I don't work for free, my friend. Now get off.
Please, I don't have any money.
Darn it.
What is it?
Something's wrong with the engine.
That's why it won't start?
Yeah, that's right. Look, could you do me a favor and push the car so I can jumpstart the engine, please?
All right, but you have to pay me $10.
Sure.
Remember, it's $10.
Yeah, yeah. Now push.
Hey, wait! Stop!
See if you can. See you around.
Hey, come back here!
You think you're tough, yeah. Jesse, huh?
Yeah.
Mom, why did you fight us? Yeah, hold him. Yeah.
That's what you get.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on. Come on. You want some more, huh? You want some more?
Here.
Here, huh? Dare you cheat us, man.
Yeah.
Come on, let's see you get down, man.
Cheating us.
Go. What you gonna get?
Let him go!
Let him go? Why, who are you?
I don't want to fight with you guys. I promised my mom. Not to get into fights anymore.
What's with this guy?
I know, he's probably crazy.
Let him go. Call your mom and I'll slap her real hard.
What'd you say?
You don't stand a chance against us.
Yeah!
Yeah, whoa, what? You're
what's
trying
that
to scare
all
us? What's yeah. with that yacht? I can do that yacht. Fine.
Look what you've done. You paid for this. Get him, man.
Want some more?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for saving me.
You're a jerk, you know that? You left me behind.
You're my guardian angel. You've rescued me.
I'm not an angel. You dumped me in the middle of the road and stole my bag.
You've nothing to worry about. I've searched your bag. Nothing valuable was in it.
My birth certificate's there. And citizenship papers.
It's all in your bag. Nothing's missing, by the way. The money you gave me, I'll give it back to you.
You don't have to.
All my life, I've asked God to send an angel to protect me. Now he answered my prayers.
Are you deaf? I told you I'm not an angel.
You're an angel. You just don't know it yet.
If I were an angel, I would have saved someone else, not a jerk like you.
Yes, you're right. I'm a jerk. I admit it. But I never killed anyone. They were the ones who wanted to kill me.
Why is that?
Because of the color of my skin. And maybe because I overcharged them. But if I were white, they wouldn't beat me.
It's because you cheated them, you dimwit.
No. That's not it. I'm black. That's the only reason why they wanted to kill me. They would have chopped me to pieces and scattered me all over Seattle if you hadn't arrived in time to rescue me.
Wouldn't the cops show up?
Yeah, they would, but after a few days to look for my dead body. The cops don't care if black people are killed. So even if I call the police, they wouldn't come to help me. It's racism. Do you understand? Racism.
After making me look stupid earlier, I wish I wasn't there to save you. You're a jerk.
You can call me any name you want. Wait, may I know your name?
You've seen my papers, right?
Then your name is Bruce Lee.
Now a jerk like you knows my name. I'm really out of luck.
Oh, you're right. I am a jerk. You can call me Jerk Jesse. Don't be mad. I'll take you back to the city.
Hello.
Oh, we're not open yet. Please come back later.
I'm looking for someone.
Huh? Who are you looking for?
Miss Ruby.
We use some of our vacant rooms here to store our old equipment. Like that one.
Where can I stay?
In here. You may have this room. It's a bit small, but it's quite clean.
This is more than enough for me.
You said you arrived yesterday. Where did you sleep last night?
Oh, last night. I spent the night inside a taxi cab.
You have a very good sense of humor. I like that. James told me that your family is quite well off in Hong Kong.
Well, we're not poor. My father is an actor and a famous Chinese opera star. So I've lived a comfortable life. I've never worried about food or a place to sleep until now.
Oh.
When I left Hong Kong, I only had $100 with me.
Just $100? Are you kidding me? Don't you know that $100 here in America can only sustain you for a month with only water to drink?
It's true, I'm not lying.
Now I know why James wanted you to come here, to get rid of a burden. So what now? What do you plan to do?
Haven't you arranged something for me? I thought you'd recommend a good school.
I mean, how will you support yourself with only $100?
That wouldn't be a problem. I'll work for you.
Work here at my restaurant?
Mm-hmm. I can do anything.
I see. All right.
Well, here's our food.
Enjoy your meal, sir.
Thank you. Here Happy you birthday, go. Dear.
Enjoy.
Happy birthday.
Here, have some more.
Come on. This is good.
Good boy.
Chef, one order of sweet and sour pork and spicy ribs.
Coming.
School?
Mm-hmm.
But what school?
Here.
This is great. Thank you so much, Miss Ruby.
Don't thank me. You should be grateful to your Uncle Chow. I've finished all the paperwork for your admission. Listen, Edison Technical School is not a prestigious school, but it's a good choice for young people like you who just came to America. If you go to school in the morning, I guess you can work part-time in the afternoon to cover your living expenses. You may still have the room in the basement for free if you want, to save you money.
Thank you, Miss Ruby. But now that I've quit my job, I have to leave the restaurant. Otherwise, Chef Huang will give you more headaches.
Don't worry about him.
Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to go to school. I'll do my best.
This is your salary for this month.
Thank you.
Here's another 200. So, you'll have money for your tuition. Wait, this is on loan, okay?
Of course. I promise I'll pay you back. May I say something?
Sure, what is it?
Don't worry, ma'am. If Chef Huang brings you any more trouble again, just let me know. I'll teach him to respect the boss.
Thank you so much, Bruce. But I can handle Chef Huang.
Okay, I gotta go.
Okay, take care. No, wait. America is like a big jungle. Only the fittest can survive this country. If you're weak, you won't stand a chance. After years of living here in America, that is the bitter truth I have learned. You have to be strong. Always show great courage. Whatever problem comes your way, never lose yourself. Trust in your abilities.
I'll remember it all.
Good luck. Oh, one more thing. When your Uncle Chow was here, he told me to give you this. You'd better take it.
Uncle Chow?
Goodbye.
Thank you for your
help. You take care of yourself, okay?
I will.
Hey, wait a minute.
What?
You must be the biggest idiot in this world. A bigger fool than I am. The owner of the restaurant offered you a place to stay for free, but you'd rather live in a place that costs money?
Don't talk nonsense. Let's go.
You must be a rich man. Anyway, I've found you a place to stay. Plus a job after school. If you want to pay for my services, I wouldn't mind.
Would you mind if I punch your face? I barely have enough money for my next meal. Come on!
So don't complain anymore. Get back to work. Hey, kid. Good work. I like how you work. Here. This is your pay for the week. Here you go.
Thank you.
Bear, man. And because he works real hard, I'll give him a bonus. Take this. Come back tomorrow. I need more people like you, okay?
Okay.
Good job.
Thanks.
want you to leave this place.
Why? I haven't done anything wrong.
All the money that was supposed to be ours were given to you. The boss reduced our pay because of you. That's unfair.
Why is it that you guys can work here and make money, but I can't?
Get him! Yeah!
My wife and kid are sick. If you stay here and work, I won't have enough money to feed them.
Here, take this.
Thank you.
I guess you must really like this place. Is it because the owner of this restaurant is also a yellow-skinned man?
Shut up! He may be yellow-skinned, but he's Japanese. I don't like how they sit. So when I'm here, I always have this table and a chair to sit on.
It's their martial arts, isn't it? You know what? This is the place where they teach Japanese karate. I've also heard that the owner of this restaurant is a highly skilled karate master.
Now you're talking some sense.
I knew you'd be interested. You don't know me real well. Do you know what they call me? The living map of Seattle.
That's great. You've earned your meal for today. Jesse, I'd like to ask you for a favor. I need a fast food delivery job, and maybe a newspaper delivery job as well.
Whoa, wait, you want two jobs? Here in America, you can't apply for two different jobs at the same time. It's illegal.
But I need money to pay for my tuition.
All right. I'll help you find two
jobs. One more favor. You call yourself the living map, right?
Yes, that's right.
Then help me find all the martial arts school here in Seattle. All the kung fu houses, not just Chinese. Could be American, Japanese, or Korean. Just find them for me.
What? Why? You want to fight them all?
Yes, you're right.
Oh, I'm sorry, Master, but I can't be your bodyguard. Okay. Actually, this restaurant is one of the best martial arts clubs in Seattle. Their students haven't lost a single fight. Now, if you can defeat everyone here, you'll be hailed as a martial arts champion in Seattle.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay. I'll defeat all the martial arts masters here. Hey! 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 Hey!
Excuse me. Hi. What's your name, kid?
I'm sorry, I'm not Japanese.
It doesn't matter. If you're interested to learn karate, you may register.
No, thanks. I'm not interested.
Well, then what are you doing here?
I want to have some fun.
Fun? We're teaching the National Martial Arts of Japan, not some children's show. If they want to sign up, you may leave.
They're learning martial arts. That's not kung fu.
What did you say? Leave now, you bastard.
You'd better be polite.
You insulted us first. Polite enough already.
What if I refuse to leave?
I'll twist your head off your neck.
Okay, no twisting. Just calm down.
You want to twist my head off? I'd like to see how you're gonna do it. Come on, show me. Maybe you can get rid of my headache.
What did you say?
I don't want to tussle with you. It's embarrassing. What I want is an open competition with you. If you can really twist my head off my neck, I'll be happy to oblige.
You'll fight with me in an open competition?
Wait, keep your heads cool. I think you've had too much to drink, Bruce. You're going to get hurt because I can't protect you.
Move.
Now I understand. This is alcohol talking. All right, since you're a customer at my restaurant, I forgive you.
I'm not drunk.
When you wake up tomorrow and you still feel the same, you may come back here. I will accept your challenge. I'll fight with you.
I want to fight with you today.
No, I'm sorry. Today I'll treat you as one of our guests. Like I said, if you still feel the same tomorrow, I'll fight with you in front of my students. We'll follow our combat rules. Now go. You've already taken enough time from my students. Leave. Continue.
She don't engine,